Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, friends. Welcome back to my channel. I received an email from my viewer saying that he is finding equivalent of SD6834 PWM IC. Can you please advise on this? And then I received another reminder email. Let's see how we can find equivalent for any PWM IC. In the first step, we will find datasheet of this SD6834. There are many websites which are sharing datasheet. We can check anyone. Let's see this one. Open in desktop. SD6834. It is current mod PWM PFM controller with built-in high voltage MOSFET. Switching frequency 67 kHz. 25 and 67 depending on the load. In open frame universal power supply it will deliver 15 watt. Here is block diagram, its internal structure. We need to check its continuous drain current, that is 2.5 ampere ID. There are two currents. The first, that is drain current pulse, that is 10 ampere. It is maximum peak current. We need to check continuous drain current at 25 degree centigrade. It is 2.5 ampere. Then the most important feature in any MOSFET, that is RDS on. Here is 3.4 ohm RDS on. When the MOSFET will turn on, its drain to source resistance will be 3.4 to 3.6 ohms. Then switching frequency. It is most important thing in any PWM IC. Then there is startup voltage, V start, 15.5 volt to 8.3 volt, upper limit, lower limit. Initially this IC will need 15.5 volt, then it will start. After that, the working voltage must be between 8.3 to 15.5. If the voltage will drop, VCC voltage will drop below 8.3 volt, this IC will turn off. Then duty cycle, 77% maximum. So these are the most important things in any SMPS controller IC. Then there are feedback signals and current sense signals. We can adjust their signals. Then pin out. What is the footprint? Pin 1 is ground, pin 2 is current sense, pin 3 is VCC, pin 4 is feedback, pin number 5 not connected, 6, 7, 8 drain pins. When we are searching for equivalent, we must select some closer footprint so that we can interchange the pins safely. Now this is our basic requirement footprint. I will share three different techniques. The first, that is remote-odd.net. Here we will select the pin numbers and their function. Pin number 8, 7, 6 drain pins. Drain 8, 7, 6 drain pins. Then pin number 5 not connected. NC pin not connected. Pin number 5. Pin 4 feedback, 3 VCC. Feedback pin 4, VCC pin number 3, ground pin number 1. Then there is current sense. Current sense option is not available here. We will press salt. This website provided 4 ICs here. SW8600, SD4840. We are already searching from the same family, SD6834. So I think we will not check this one. But we can check this one, SA0565. Let's see its datasheet. SA0565 datasheet. Here is DM0565, SA065 datasheet. So it is not giving any data about this IC. Sometimes there are some strange numbers that we cannot find any data for that ICs. Might be this IC DM0565, but this IC, it is different. It is from Fairchild. I think it is not 8-pin IC. Yes, it has same switching frequency, 66 kilohertz, and its working voltage are also same. Its drain current is 2.8 ampere. We can also use this IC. RDS on is better than our required IC. Then duty cycle 80%, that's good. And working voltage are also within that limit. Now the switching frequency is same, duty cycle same, working voltage upper limit 12 volt, lower limit 8 volt. So this IC will remain in that window. Let me open it in desktop. We will need to change the pins. Pin number 1 will go to drain. The same procedure which I demonstrated in video number 972C. You can watch this video on my channel, that how we can convert the pins of any IC. It is 972C. I will share the link in the video description. That is LG Inverter AC Outdoor Unit Board Part 4 SMPS Repair. If we are using this IC, we will need to add a startup resistor, that is VSTR resistor, between positive rail and pin number 6, because this IC needs STR resistor at pin number 6. In this IC, there is startup resistor at pin number 3, but in this IC, we need to connect this resistor, 100K resistor, at pin number 6 and positive DC rail. VCC capacitor is connected at pin number 3. So we need to rearrange this resistor that is connected at pin number 3, and we need to connect at pin number 6 of this IC. We need to alter the circuit, because in this IC 0565, pin number 6 will provide charging current to VCC capacitor, that is its internal circuit. Okay, let's check some other examples. Then we have SA482. Check this IC, SA482. SA482, it is also the same family from the same manufacturer. It is 14 watt. Continuous drain current 2 ampere. In the original IC, continuous drain current 2.5 ampere. So this IC will not work nicely. We will skip this one. Its pin out is same. This IC don't have current sense pin, but this IC will work similar to that IC, but its power rating is less than our required IC. But if this IC is available, we can use this one as well. Then we can check SW8601. SW8604, that is 18 watt. We can use this one or this one, because our required power rating is 15 watt. ID, so 8603 and 04 are best replacement for that IC, because 8603 has 3 ampere and this one 4 ampere. Now we will check frequency. Yes, oscillator frequency, that is 67 kilohertz, and working voltage V start 12 volt and 8 volt, that are exactly in the same working window of this IC, 15.5 and 8.3. So we have an option to use this IC. Then we need to check RDS on. That's nice. 4 ohms and 3 ohms. So these two numbers can be used as a replacement. Now we will check the pin out. Signal ground, power ground, VCC, feedback. If we will use this IC, at that time current sense signal will be removed from the board and pin 1 and 2 will be grounded. So this IC will work normally. 8603 and 04 have same footprint. So we can use these two ICs. Then the next method, type here 15 watt, which we discussed here in the start, that our required watt rating is 15 watt, 67 kilohertz SMPS IC. STRA6251, we can check its data sheet. STRA6251, 67 kilohertz flyback switching regulator, 15 watt. Its ID is drain current 2.5 ampere, that is exactly matching to our required IC, 67 kilohertz. Duty cycle 76%, that's nice. RDS on 3.95, so it will not heat up, it will work nicely. And its working window is also the same, 14.3 and 10 volt. Might be the working voltage may differ. If there is a resistor in the auxiliary winding section, we can remove to increase the VCC voltage that are coming from auxiliary winding. But here we need to rearrange the pins as per this configuration. Now we can check some other IC. The same which I used, ICE3BR1065 IC, in my last video that I discussed here, 972C. We can use this IC as well. We can check one by one from these ICs. Anyone that is matching footprint and working voltage, so that IC can be used. This family, FSDH0265 and FSDM0265, in this family there is LMH. L is low frequency, M is medium frequency, H is high frequency. Our required watt rating, that is 16 watt. So we can select FSDM0365. This IC will work, and 265 will work also as a replacement. 165 will also, but we will select M because M, that is medium frequency. Pin number 876, drain pins, pin 1 ground, pin 2 VCC. In our required IC, pin 3 is VCC, so we need to rearrange the pins. Then pin number 4, I peak. There is option, we can select this IC as well. Duty cycle 77%. As I discussed, there is difference in part number. FSDH, that is 100 kilohertz. FSDM, this M, it is medium frequency, it is 67 kilohertz. And its working voltage are exactly the same, 12 volt and 8 volt within that window. Just we need to alter the pins. And then there is another option, we can use DigiKey. digikey.com. Search here AC to DC offline switcher. Here we need internal switch, yes. Then we need switching frequency 67 kilohertz. 67 kHz. Duty cycle 72%, 74%, 75, 77, 83%. Apply. In the first step, we will check any available item. In this table, there are different parameters available here. Now we can refine our search. Switching frequency 67 kHz. Any watt rating that is closer to our required value, we can select that one. And then we can check any closest number that will match to our PCB footprint. That will much better. And now we can refine the voltage here. Startup voltage 12 volt, 13, 15, 15.3. Apply. Now here is a complete list. We can select these ICs. There are data sheets available here. We can study data sheets, and any IC which is matching to our working voltage, duty cycle, switching frequency, watt rating, and its pin out is matching to our PCB or slightly closer, we can alter some pins and we can use it. I hope this video is informative. If it is good, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.